Have you or a friend ever been duped by fake news? I'm Spandi Singh, a policy analyst at the Open Technology Institute, and I'm here to explain how AI powers the spread of viral myths and disinformation, from fake celebrity deaths to political attacks and medical mistruths. First, let's unpack the difference. Misinformation is factually inaccurate information that's spread accidentally, and disinformation is false content that's spread intentionally to deceive. Over the past 2 years, we have seen internet platforms radically change the policies and practices they deploy to tackle both misinformation and disinformation. Many platforms, including Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and TikTok, rely at least in part on AI and machine learning tools to curate and shape the content we see online. They use different techniques to combat misleading information. For example, they might label content related to topics like vaccines and link to credible sources where users can fact-check what they're seeing. Or they might use algorithms to reduce how many people see suspected misleading content in their news feeds. But we only know how these techniques work in a broad sense. Platforms don't share a lot of information about how their algorithms work, when they use these tools, or what results they see from their interventions. So we don't know how effective they are at combating misinformation and disinformation. Even worse, because these platforms also rely on AI to optimize their content delivery, their systems may actually be promoting misleading information. Today, platforms use AI-driven tools that optimize content delivery to perform tasks such as content ranking and recommendation, ad targeting and delivery, and content moderation. What does that look like? Companies commonly use ranking and recommendation algorithms to curate the content people see by algorithmically sorting and ranking content, like in a newsfeed, or by algorithmically recommending content, such as suggesting which video to watch next. Ranking and recommendation systems deliver relevant content to people, but relevance is a subjective term, and generally, platforms design these systems to optimize for engagement. That is to say, they want someone to do something when they see the post, such as click, react, share, or comment, not just scroll on by. Imagine a false news story about a celebrity death. It has a photo of a famous face next to some shocking news. A lot of people are going to click on it, telling the algorithm that the content is engaging and therefore relevant, even if the story is not true. While this might seem harmless, the same thing can happen with content that plays on people's political biases or health fears. This content is often more engaging from the algorithm's perspective, of course, than the truth. In this way, both ranking and recommendation algorithms can profoundly shape a user's online experience and determine what kind of information they see and how they see the world. Online advertising is also a key component of the internet ecosystem, forming a large portion of many internet platforms' business models. With hundreds of billions of dollars on the table, platforms rely on AI to enhance and scale their ad targeting and delivery operation. Automated tools play many roles in the online advertising space. One of their most important jobs is to shape which ads are delivered to users and when. When an advertiser wants to run an ad, they will enter some details about who they want to reach, like their age, location, and interests. But advertising algorithms refine the ad targeting process even further, eventually delivering the ad to the exact people they calculate are most likely to click, watch, or take some other desired action. This can result in ads being delivered to an even smaller and more niche audience than the advertiser initially specified. For example, imagine an advertiser wants to reach women in the US who are between 25 and 35 years old, but the algorithm discovers that the people most likely to click on the ad are women who are between 25 and 27 years old who like dogs and live in Washington, DC. From that point on, no cat-loving 33-year-old New Yorker will see that ad. This may seem harmless if an ad is for clothes or other consumer goods, but when political or issue-based ads only reach a very small community, they can contribute to the creation of filter bubbles and help spread false narratives that go unchecked or unchallenged by the wider public. Without meaningful transparency from internet platforms, it's hard to determine how advertised content may be spreading disinformation or influencing targeted audiences. Most social media platforms moderate content shared on their platforms to enforce their content policies, which determine what content individuals and groups are permitted to share on their services. Using AI to identify and remove misinformation and disinformation online has certain benefits for both social media companies and users. Primarily, these algorithmic tools allow companies to flag, review, and remove content at scale and limit how much harmful content human content moderators have to see and how much ultimately appears in users' feeds. But algorithmic systems are not sophisticated enough to distinguish different types of content, such as hate speech, misinformation or disinformation, non-harmful speech, and satire. Most content moderation algorithms are trained on a small subset of languages and examples. As a result, these systems cannot understand nuances and how language is used globally, such as slang words in different languages, and they also cannot understand the cultural context of each post that they review. A piece of content or certain word may be inoffensive in one country or language, but outrageous to use in a different global context. Because of these limitations, algorithmic content moderation systems may not always catch harmful content, resulting in such content spreading online. At times, they can also flag and remove unproblematic content, raising concerns around freedom of speech online. Thus far, internet platforms have not provided much insight into how they use AI and machine learning tools to tackle misleading information online. As we've seen over the past few years, the consequences of this kind of content going viral are significant and often impact already vulnerable communities. With a heightened focus and algorithmic accountability from policymakers around the world, there's a good opportunity to advance government oversight and push platforms to take more responsibility for the technologies they deploy. As first steps, we'll be advocating for stronger privacy protections and increased transparency.